Ministry of Industry and Production, Government of Pakistan, as a not-for-profit organization. It's a Section 42 company and working as a not-for-profit. This is the same international model of one village, one product, which is being practiced in Far Eastern Asian countries, and now we have seen in South African countries also. And the same concept is run by the government. One village, one product concept was initiated first of all in the world in Oita, Japan. And the concept behind it was to use local people resources by local people decide what they wish to use by utilizing the maximum resources of local materials which are available in the rural areas. And same replicated worldwide. The basic objective of this organization is to alleviate poverty through emphasis on direct benefit to wage earners, women, poor producer groups, artisans, and craft persons. Because you see, this is a, there is a sector which is a cotton industry, we could say, cotton industry. And we work within that cotton industry. There is another sector which is using handicrafts and handmade products. So our main focus is on that sector. So we are supporting employment generation activities and enhancing competitiveness and viability of small businesses and their products in rural and semi-urban areas. How we do that? This is the methodology, and by supporting artisans, craft persons, and food producer groups through initiating small projects. It depends on the duration of every project is like 3 months to 12 months. And it depends on the cluster size and dynamics of the cluster and the product. And to make their products competitive the local, national, and international market. You can see our outreach. We started in 2006 and today we are sitting in 2016. For the last approximately 10 years, we have covered 148 areas, which means 148 projects have been completed. So far, we covered 75 districts of the country, 95 partner organizations have been worked with us, which includes UNHCR, USAID, UKG, and so far. And up till now, we have supported directly 37,900 partners. Who are our partners? They consist of fashion designers, fashion schools, educational institutes, NGOs, government institutions, district governments, chamber of commerce and industries, small industries corporations like we have in Punjab, small industries and like since small industries at provincial level, and international government agencies like UNHCR or other organizations. How we intervene? We do basically four areas. First of all, we develop the capacity of the artisans to be skill enhancement, and the basic backbone of our organization is we eventually are master. We feel that is product development and design. We want fashion designers in the clusters. They go in the clusters and they produce all the samples along with the artisans at their doorstep. And we go through the sampling and then marketing these products. So therefore, the artisans can replicate the same activities. And quality assurance, we set some standards and communicate to them what are the standards which are acceptable in the local market, which are acceptable in the international markets, don't go beyond those standards or plans. And by the end of the project, we always do the marketing activities, which consist of developing catalogs, doing professional photo shoots, conducting exhibitions for the artisans, and show them if we can do these activities along with them, they can also. So it encourages that. How the project is initiated, this is just a general idea. We identify a product having potential in the market. Number of product persons should be sufficient. Like we don't work in any area which have less than 20 participants. And number of direct and indirect beneficiaries should be 24-5. And general distribution should be kept in view. Current income per person is reported before initiating any project, and we do the tax assessment post project implementation. So we compare those income. Sale price versus cost price, there should be a potential of margin earning, and we do sort of assessment for the value chain. So ad area and product. Existing market for the sale, where is the existing market, why they did not go to another new markets. So these are basic ideas to initiate project. This is a snapshot of which type of products in which we have worked so far. In textile, every region has its own specific priority. Like if you go to Khepatulha, we find Pulkari, like Justine Embroidery. There are different names of the embroidery. And if you come to Punjab, we have French Knot, we have Kacha Danga. So we covered almost 40 types of embroideries in the country by developing their capacities of the articles. And embroidery and pattern making, we work in cutting, stitching, ajrak making, hand fabric, and so far. And we worked also in ceramics, in terracotta, red clay, and blue pottery also. And in silverware, wood craft, leather craft, and marble mosaic. This is also a snapshot of how many beneficiaries have been supported by us in the last 10 years. And you can see we got 27,000 partisans. Pakistan, 7,000 KPK, about 10,000 Punjab, and same as Pakistan. These are some of the specimens of the products which we produce. It's an example of how we add a value in any product. What are the contributions of our organization? You can see this is a lady's clutch, and you can see the embellished piece of fabric beneath this clutch. In the past, the artisans used to sell unfinished product in, let's say, in approximately 500 rupees. But when we taught them to come to Lahore, Karachi, and convert it to a finished product, and after spending approximately 400 to 500 rupees on finishing it, now they are selling this type of product in rupees 2,000. But previously, they were selling it. So this is how margin can be added by adding a value in a product. It's also an example. You can see the fabric on this clutch is a we call it a case in our local language. It's a pet spread or pet sheet. And this was also used as a to make a clutch. These are also clutches, but made up of ajrak fabric. You can see this is the blue pottery. You have seen in the market in blue color, but we added green color. Like in this picture, we added orange color and made a new product in the market to earn more. This is also terracotta. This was a simple product previously, but we added embossed it with the cast of Paris and much better. These are cushion covers, but some of the artists were making presses previously, but we communicated them. They can make a new product line also. And these are the photo shoots we conduct after every project. So this is when we provide them on a catalog and print for them on our expenses. This is the way they can meet the potential customers like fabrication daily or very fair or so far. So it enhances the credibility and the we converted it on a wooden box. So it has become another new product in the market. This is one of the exhibitions we conducted in Lahore. So this is the final slide, and I would like to show you why Lahore is different from other vocational training centers, because we conduct trainings at the doorstep. We conduct trainings at the village. We don't bring them to any center or to any urban area. So the basic idea is to keep them in their own area and earn in their own homeland. Craft-specific training, we don't conduct general training. We assess the level of the articles, level of the group, and then design. And product development training under supervision of designers, fashion designers and interior designers. We hire them from NCA or KIOT or any known institution. Formation of group and group leaders by AHAN, elimination of middlemen. Exposure visits for beneficiaries are conducted after every project. And step-by-step training on marketing products, which have been discussed. And market linkages are developed for them, like we are doing it with every cluster. And training on value-added products. Thank you very much.